We are right to start the next talk. This time, I see fiber deployments using open WRT. Have a round of applause.
Hey guys. Okay. My name is Brian. My coworker is Jorge. Our level English is little log, but speaking in English. Okay. The conference is Fiber Optical Project deployed with Open WRT. Next, please. First, what is Bogota Mesh Community Network? And Bogota exists a community, network community, of providers access to technology at different persons that not is difficult, access to internet. And Bogota exists zones the people lives with $2 per day. Also, not have access to different tools solution. Yes. In special, our notes. Our location at rural zones, and rural zones and Colombia. This is zones no have a technology, no have no exists internet in rural zones and Colombia. Also, we logged a building nodes for reduce breast per device, digital devices. We are a Batman, we are open WRT.
Now, ahora is association ISP is Calemas. La idea, si me ayudas.
Okay.
La idea implementation deployed fiber optic con OpenWRT en el esquema mapa se tiene todo el backbone.
So you have all that backbone over there.
La capa de fibra óptica.
The fiber optic layer.
Que en fibra óptica es FTTH o EOC que es Ethernet over the coax.
So a combination of fiber and coax.
En esta parte los modem o la ONT portamos OpenWRT.
En la primera milla optamos por usar OpenWRT.
En inglés. En inglés. Sí.
Sí.
En inglés.
Sorry. The first mile we choose to do. Sorry. To use OpenWRT.
Entonces, lo interesante de esta parte es que la capa de fibra óptica interactúa con equipos que están bajo OpenWRT.
So the most part here is the fiber optics and coaxial network coexists and collaborate with with OpenWRT devices.
Bueno, en el diseño de fibra óptica se debe tener cuidado en el diseño porque en pérdidas se mira la pérdida de señal. Actualmente contamos con 120 kilómetros de fibra óptica troncal, fibra óptica de 96 hilos y tenemos 700 hilos disponibles.
So, when you design fiber optics devices, you have to be careful with the loss. And now they have 72 fiber cables with around that amount of fiber optic cables around.
Entonces, aquí está el trabajo porque en el esquema hemos visto, esto está ya en producción, un nodo Llega aquí la parte de fibra óptica desde nuestro backbone.
Sorry. Puedes repetir.
En la parte ya en producción, esta parte es un punto de fibra óptica que llega desde nuestro backbone, que está a 10 kilómetros, y aquí convertimos a fibra óptica, a coaxial.
Okay, este equipo so in that's production part of, so it's part of their production infrastructure, and they get there with fiber.
Y equipos tienen OpenWRT y se hace la conversión de fibra a coaxial.
So those devices have OpenWRT and convert fiber to coaxial.
En esa parte aquí ya miramos cómo con los equipos con los que tienen OpenWRT está conectado la interfaz a estos equipos acá.
So over there you can see that you can they are interacting through the Ethernet cable with the OpenWRT device that does that translation from fiber to coaxial.
Entonces, en las pruebas y ya en producción, lo que vemos es que nuestra la interfaz WAN, actualmente también el cable modem cuenta con OpenWRT, y en el testeo vemos que en la red coaxial, pues varios equipos.
So in the infrastructure you can see there, the end the devices also has OpenWRT coaxial. It's an OpenWRT router with coaxial interface, and over there you can see that the cables are providing connectivity to multiple devices at the same time.
Actualmente tenemos 1,200, más de 1,200 modems desplegados en el sur de Bogotá, y el tráfico de salida de internet es promedio 3 terabytes.
So right now they have more than 1,200?
Sí.
So more than 1,200 devices in their network with one. How many terabytes?
3 terabytes.
With a bandwidth of 3 terabytes. Terabits. Terabits.
Cantidad de tráfico.
So, amount of traffic. Right. Sorry.
En ancho de banda tenemos dos proveedores de salida a internet. Cada uno es de 300 megabytes. Megabits.
So they have two uplink. Links of 300 megabits each.
Los retos en esa tecnología en FTTH y EOC, seguir dando hardware que funcione en esa en tecnología con OpenWRT.
Big challenges has been about migrating OpenWRT to those devices that use fiber to the home or coaxial cable technology.
Porque pues al portar OpenWRT a esa tecnología se abre un mundo de posibilidades para este hardware.
So when you make OpenWRT work on those devices, you have a big amount of opportunities with the devices that you had no before.
I'm sorry. okay. Gracias a llevar la fibra a zonas muy pobres de la ciudad, hemos podido lograr que crear nodos por medio de la fibra y por medio de fundaciones o salones comunitarios proveer diferentes servicios gracias a Bogotá Mesh y Cable Más.
So, thanks to having this infrastructure and with the help of many local NGOs and organizations, we have been able to bring connectivity to the farther places and poorer ones.
Sí, entonces esto es supremamente importante para nosotros porque en Colombia el acceso a la fibra es muy complejo, muy complicado.
So this is very important for us because in Colombia getting to use fiber optic technologies is very complex.
Or reverse engineering, or you are using a
Okay, I will repeat the question so it gets the stream, the streaming. Okay, so the question is, if you have implemented drivers for the FTTH and the coaxial thing, or if you have been using something already done or something like that? Or if they're using a binary blob, okay.
Sí, no, el driver estuvo hecho porque es una broadcon. Entonces, cuando probé que era el data chip, vi que estaba soportado por OpenWRT y ya. Entonces, porque
One sentence at a time. Thank you. So, when you got to, when he got to do that, he found out that it was a Broadcom device and it was already available. Okay.
Entonces, vi el datasheet porque traía el firmware propietario. Entonces, de hecho, el firmware original es muy limitado. Solamente puedes conectar un usuario por PPOE. O de HCP y ya. Entonces,
the current implementation was closed source, and the features that were available were too limited for your needs.
Yes, we are building OpenWRT and this is device because the firmware for default is very limited. Also, this device supports OpenWRT, and this device is possible a translator or coaxial. And another question? Yes?
You can trust me. Okay. What I did not understand is OpenWRT running directly on the router with the coaxial interface, or do you use the modem just like a modem? So the PPPoE stuff is running on a normal OpenWRT router. So again, is OpenWRT running on the coaxial interface with an open driver?
Sí, yes. OpenWRT installer en el cable modem, la interfaz one entra. Entonces el OpenWRT sí está instalado en este dispositivo.
So that device has OpenWRT installed, and the one interface gets into the device through coaxial.
More question? Gracias.
So you're using this coaxial network. Did you have to build it yourself, or was this already available? Because normally when you do internet over coaxial, it's normally that you have the network already due to, you know, TV service, and you're just upgrading it to internet. But I think you're using it just for internet and build it yourself, but maybe you can clarify.
La parte inicial había una red en coaxial, HFC, un hybrid coaxial and fiber, y se adaptó para proveer internet y cualquier servicio que funcione bajo la capa TCP o UDP.
So there was a network already deployed, a hybrid coaxial and fiber network, and it was adapted to work for other services.
More question?
So one question is, this initiative is being pushed by, I know you, but the network that you are talking about, like these cables that are already deployed, are community owned, are a private or company that owns the cables, who owns the infrastructure?
As
El dueño de la infraestructura actualmente está es asociado entre Cable Más y la red comunitaria que es Bogotá Mesh. Lo interesante es que
sorry. One sentence at a time. So not infrastructure is in between Bogotá Mesh and the Cable Más company.
Lo interesante de esta parte es llegar a ofrecer internet a muy bajo costo y ofrecer servicios dentro de la misma red que cualquier operador tradicional en Colombia no deja hacer.
So the interesting part here is that by using these technologies you can provide services at a very, very low cost and something about the rest of providers that don't let you do that or something like that. Sorry, I couldn't.
Hi, so what are the actual costs?
En Colombia, una conexión a internet de 5 megas te cuesta alrededor de $40.
So in Colombia, ¿qué velocidad?
En Colombia,
a 5 megabit connection costs you $50 per month. $40 per month.
Nosotros en la venta de internet 5 megas cuesta $12.
With Bogotá Mesh and Cable Más, getting 5 megabits through the network costs $12.
Yeah, but what's the cost of deployment? How much does like the server part and the client part or the modem, the dial-up stuff cost?
En la transporte que es de fibra, puede seguir este equipo si son chinos. Es muy económico, pero la idea es comprar hardware de buena calidad, pero cuesta promedio $3,000.
¿Cuánto?
$3,000.
So the access layer, the Chinese devices that you can use can cost around
$3,000. Y llegar al usuario final, un cable modem que cuesta de $40 de baja calidad, $50 de alta calidad.
So the device, the access device, the PPPoA device, costs around between $40 and $50. And what, y la infraestructura, los cables y eso?
Conseguir una carreta, de 5 kilómetros, $2,500.
¿Una carreta de qué cable?
De fibra óptica y coaxial.
Lo mismo.
Sí.
Okay, so a 5 kilometer cable, no matter if it's coaxial or fiber, costs around?
¿Cuánto?
$2,500.
More question?
Who is the manufacturer, the supplier of the cable modem? Because I guess it's difficult to find one a cable modem where you can have a chance to install OpenWRT.
El proveedor es una empresa china, pero el hardware es Broadcom, y ya le muestro el link.
So the company is a Chinese company. The hardware is Broadcom's. So and the provider, he's going to show it to you there.
Pero el reto también para nosotros es seguir ampliando esa cobertura de hardware con OpenWRT.
So the challenge for them is to expand the support for other devices using OpenWRT.
Es el dispositivo, pero la idea es ampliar la capacidad.
So that's the device, but the idea is to expand.
Con OpenWRT.
Okay, its capacity with OpenWRT.
Are there open source drivers for the cable part?
No, hardware, IOC, FTTH, open source, no.
No, no es open hardware.
More question?
What are the other costs, municipal taxes, to put this deployment of optical fiber? I mean, bueno, you understand? Bueno, en, ¿cuáles son los costes de las licencias, de las tasas que os aplica el gobierno por pasar la fibra? Porque entiendo que la fibra pasa subterránea. Y esto tiene unos costes añadidos, es obra civil, creo, ¿no? Un poco esto.
So, question is are there any other costs that are involved in the project besides the infrastructure, things like taxes and costs related to deployment? And because fiber, putting fiber in a city requires doing civil interventions, and that costs money.
En Colombia, adquirir fibra óptica o cable coaxial no es costoso, pero la, el desarrollo y pago de licencia sí. Una licencia.
So in Colombia, acquiring the technological, the infrastructure part is cheap, but the paying the taxes are not cheap at all.
El pago de permisos de por donde pasa la fibra en un poste, pagas $1 por cable que pasa en un poste.
¿Por cable por metro o por cable por...?
Por cable poste. Que pasa en el poste. Y subterráneo, so, $2 mensual.
So, if you want to put a cable on a pole, on a
si
city pole, it costs you to the... one pole.
Yeah.
So...
I could buy $1 for the salt. Yes, yes.
And if you want to go underground, it costs $2 instead of one.
For is, the same. The low is cost for salt, but is a high cost. Different salts, más costs.
Yeah. Or posts.
Exactly. Most post, most cost.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, guys.